Hello, here is the bonus material on reduced neuron models where I explain extensions to the integrated fire models that make it more accurate. What's not such a good assumption was to ignore the other ion channels because those ion channels can regulate strongly the dynamics before reaching the action potential and therefore change whether you have or have not generated an action potential. So what we're going to do is consider an extension of the leaky-integrate-fire that is called a generalized-integrate-fire. And the approach here is to replace the complex nonlinear equations that would normally go to describe the currents flowing from the ion channels with linear equations. And I will describe how accurate this is. So what does it mean? Let us introduce a current, W, that is inhibitory, meaning that when W is positive, V tends to decrease. I've added a sum here, meaning that there can be multiple such currents with different parameters. The parameters are the timescale tau and the coupling with the membrane potential A that can be strong, can be positive, can be negative. And the current will evolve following linear dynamics, as can be seen by this linear ordinary differential equation. And this is what we call a linear subthreshold current. It introduces additional timescales to the membrane dynamics. One example of such effect can be seen here. When you give a step increase in current, instead of a monoexponential relaxation to a stationary point, you have this overshoot that is followed by sometimes even an undershoot and then reaches the stationary point. This non-monoexponential relaxation is due to this subthreshold current that is acting exactly in that period of time. More importantly, the generalized integrated fire also captures spike frequency adaptation. So spike frequency adaptation is the process of neurons adapting to a certain stimulation, meaning that their interspike interval increases gradually with time when an input is not changing but remains constant and stimulating. This can be seen here. We have a supra-threshold current step and the interspike interval is increasing. This is seen in almost all cells. Almost all cells are showing some degree of spike frequency adaptation. The integrated fire model is not able to reproduce this. It will always have exactly the same interspike interval for a given input current intensity. So what we can do is have this adaptation current increasing, jumping up whenever there's a spike, and then to follow this linear dynamics. So we call that a spike-triggered current. And within the equations framework, we add this spike-triggered current to the threshold condition, such that whenever we reach a threshold and we say we're emitting a spike, not only do we reset the membrane potential to some potential EL, but we also make a jump by BK here, and then we follow the same dynamics. This is what we call the linearized spike-triggered current. Another process that is also able to make spike frequency adaptation that I haven't talked about here is the process of the threshold itself being dynamic, such that whenever we spike, the threshold is moving up and can decay following linear dynamics. This is seen in real neurons, and real neurons, at least the excitatory neurons, are very frequently showing this sort of moving threshold. Now we'll test our model accuracy. To do this, we inject a time-dependent current in real neurons, taken in slides from the cortex. The neuron receives an input current that looks a lot like what it would normally receive in vivo. The response are spikes in time. The goal of our mathematical neuron model is to predict those spikes, that is, to use the knowledge of the input current and some of the response to calibrate the model parameters, and then let the model evolve, let it spike, and test whether the spike times arrive at the correct place. Our metric will be having the correct spike timing plus or minus 4 milliseconds. We normalize that total number of correct spike time predictions by a measure of intrinsic variability, because neurons are not perfectly deterministic. You give them the same input multiple times and they won't always respond at the same time. So we take this into account. Now, how is the model comparison looking like? Well, the leaky integrate and fire, maybe not so surprisingly, is not particularly good at predicting the responses. The leaky integrate and fire captures 40% of the model variability, of the neuron's variability, sorry. The generalized integrate and fire, by taking into account adaptive features, is reaching 80% in terms of model accuracy. This is just as much as a much more complicated model based on nonlinear dynamics of the ion channels opening and closing on the cell membrane. That's called the Hodgkin-Huxley type model. Now, these results depend on the particular cell type that was used for doing that analysis. This was made on excitatory cells. So that is most of the cortex is made of those excitatory cells. If we look instead on the inhibitory cells, the generalized integrate and fire model is capturing 100% of the predictable spike times. So it's arguably the simplest model that has the highest accuracy for those cells. So overall, the take home from all this is that neurons act approximately as integrate and fire models. But generalized integrate and fire models integrate some adaptive features, and that allows this model, without much more complexity, to capture the behavior of real cells.